Hey, what's up, my fish tank guys and girls? We are back with the Fluval EVO 13.5 gallon aquarium. And today we are going to be talking about move rocks around, make look pretty, otherwise known as aquascaping. Okay, so when it comes to aquascaping your aquarium, this isn't going to be a really long video because there is no absolute science when it comes to setting up your brand new reef tank. Now, the reason I want to create this video is because some people just dump their sand in, place their rocks wherever, and they're off to the races. Now, one of the things you want to remember is once you have your aquarium set up, most often you won't be doing a lot of rearranging of your rocks, moving them around, different things like that, unless you got a lot of time and a lot of patience, especially when it comes to reacclimating coral and different things like that. So before you start your reef tank, one thing you definitely want to do is you want to plan out your aquascape. You want to try some different combinations. You want to see what looks best and what you think will function best for the type of aquarium that you are setting up. Now, obviously, this can depend on a few different factors. What kind of coral are you keeping? Are you doing a fish-only tank when it comes to saltwater? Some people do fish-only. Now, depending on your setup, you may want to have some caves, some overpasses for your fish, especially if you plan on keeping fish that are more sensitive or easily scared. You want to have some hiding places for them within your aquarium. So one of the things that I actually recommend doing is putting your rocks into your tank before you have anything else, before your water, before your sand. You can, you know, put the rocks in with sand in if you'd like, but I personally just do rocks all by themselves. And actually, to preserve the tank itself, right? Most of your tanks have a glass bottom, such as this one, the Fluval EVO 13.5 gallon aquarium. To preserve that bottom of your aquarium, you're gonna wanna put something down to protect it, especially if you're moving rocks around and shifting them. You might be sliding them. You might accidentally kind of drop it a little bit, right? So what I do is I measure the inside of the aquarium. I do the inside dimensions, and then I simply cut a piece of cardboard out of an old box from, you know, Amazon Prime or some shipping box or whatever. I cut out a piece of cardboard that will fit inside the aquarium. I place it down, and then I can move my rocks around however I'd like. Now, I'm going to zoom in and give you guys a closer look at this particular setup. This is not going to be the setup that I go with in my aquarium, but one thing you'll notice here is there are no kind of over slash underpasses for fish to swim through. There's no swim throughs, and that's something that I'd like to incorporate. Now, in addition, due to the way that these rocks are situated, they cast some pretty heavy shadows on some sections of the aquarium near the sand bed. That's because the rocks are sort of angled, right? So in looking at the composition of these rocks, I'm seeing that, you know, I will have a lot of space, medium to high in the tank to place coral. So if I were doing a lot of corals that have higher light level requirements, this might be an interesting setup. But if I'm going to be doing, you know, corals that are maybe ones you place on the sand bed, or they can't stand higher levels of light, I might not have as many options here. One other thing you want to definitely consider, one thing I liked about this option is that each piece of rock is kind of its own island, right? It's not connected to the others. Now, if you're planning on having any sort of like what would be considered nuisance corals, like GSP, for example, or maybe pulsing zinnias, it's a nice idea to have an island in your aquarium. That way you can put that nuisance coral on that island, and it's a much easier to prevent it from taking over your tank. So, okay, I'm going to take a brief break, and I'm going to set up the aquascape the way I'm going to keep it moving forward the way that it's going to be for the duration of the tank. Obviously, things might change in the future, but for the foreseeable future, I'm going to switch everything out and put it the way it's going to be so you can guys see what the final aquascape is going to be in this bad boy. Okay, so here is the final setup of the aquarium that I'm going to go with. It might change a little bit from this. I might experiment with how the rock on the top is balanced between the other two rocks, but I will give you guys close-ups from each side of the aquascape so you can get a better look and a better feel of what it's going to finally look like when the aquarium is set up, which I'm going to start doing finally. Yes. Now, the reason that I went with this design, I took out the largest of the large rocks. I don't want the aquarium too filled with rocks. I'm kind of on the edge because I still feel like there's a lot of rock in here for the size of the tank, but I think it's kind of a good in between, in the middle type of thing. Now, one of the things that I really like about this setup is that it does have a pass-through underneath the rock there for fish to swim through, and it also has, it still maintains one of those island components. I have the smallest of my rock kind of in the front here, separate from all the other ones, so if I want to put some GSP on there, some zinnias like I mentioned before, I can do that and I don't have to worry about them taking over the aquarium. Now, the other thing that I like about this setup is it looks very different depending on the side that you look at it. I'll give you guys close-ups on both sides. But actually, on the outside here, there's not as much flat rock to be seen because this rock has one side that's kind of very, very vertical kind of. There's no ledges and there's no things on this side of it. So this side of the tank is kind of like, you know, more flat, right? But on the other side, which is what I'll show you guys, is there are a lot of ledges and a lot of depth and dimension to the setup of this aquascape. And honestly, more often than not, I will be sitting on the other side of the aquarium because that's where my desk is and that's where my computer is at. So when I'm editing videos or working on things, just browsing the internet, whatever, I'll be on that side and I'll have a really nice view of the aquarium. So as I mentioned, guys, this is going to be a shorter video, not a lot of science when it comes to aquascaping. There are a few other things you can keep in mind when putting your rock work together, in terms of like flow of your tank, where your power head's going to be located. You definitely don't want to have rocks up in front of your primary return because then your water won't circulate and flow through the aquarium very good. So that's something else to consider. But I think probably the biggest aspect is just taking your time, moving things around, seeing what works best for you and also works best based on what you want to put into the aquarium. If you're going to do fish only, you don't have to worry about as many surfaces to put coral, but if you want to have a coral filled tank, hey, maybe you want to have a lot of surfaces. Some people go with no layering, so some people don't have this upper layer here, and that's fine. A lot of people go with a more simple approach. Some people pile their rocks up against the back wall. I personally don't like to go that route because I don't feel like you can clean that back wall if you ever need to get in there and get algae or whatnot off of it. But yeah, it works for a lot of people and that's perfectly fine. So it's really up to personal preference. So I think the biggest thing is just take good care of your tank, keep it safe in terms of putting something down. If you're gonna be working with your rock work a lot in case you drop one or you scrape one along the bottom, you don't want to scratch your glass or potentially crack your glass. So that's probably the biggest thing to keep in mind, at least that's consistent in terms of aquascaping that everyone can take into consideration as a best practice while they're doing it. But the end result kind of depends on you and what you like. So once again, I'm the Fish Tank Guy. Thank you so much for checking out my channel. I'm up to like 17,000 subs now. You guys are awesome. Keep it coming. Keep sending people over, post a link, share stuff if you'd like. I'd really appreciate it. I'm gonna finally get going on this series here. It's been a lot harder because this tank is in one of my main rooms and there's people down here all the time. This is my lower basement. There's people down here all the time playing video games, watching movies, whatever. So it's hard for me to film quite as often, but I'm hoping to get the sand in this guy, get the rock work in place, and then fill it up and start the cycling process. And I hope you guys join me for the ride. I'm really excited. So that's all I've got to say. Follow me on Twitter or Instagram at RealFishTankGuy. And until a future Fish Tank Guy video, I will see you guys soon.